The Te Whatu Ora worker accused of accessing sensitive health data which ended up online has today appeared in court. His actions have left the health agency scrambling to recover the data and reassure the public the COVID-19 vaccine is safe. Kushla Norman reports.
The IT worker at the centre of a serious breach of health data. Barry Young appearing in the Wellington District Court. The 56-year-old is accused of taking personal information from his workplace Te Whatu Ora. The agency says he was trying to spread misinformation about vaccine-related deaths.
This is an isolated incident. This is a staff member who has been working in health for almost 5 years, pre-COVID times, and he's grossly breached our trust. And this is a person who had access to information as part of doing his job. He's a serious, a senior IT leader.
Te Whatu Ora says Barry Young downloaded a large amount of data. On Saturday, some of it appeared anonymised on an overseas website. The agency sought an injunction to stop further information being published.
We have and are serving orders on websites that have shown screenshots of our information, and they are ongoing.
New Zealand websites or overseas websites?
Yes, to New Zealand websites, and we have used them to leverage overseas websites.
Te Whatu Ora says there's no evidence the vaccine has caused excess mortality. And official data shows there have been 4 deaths possibly linked to the vaccine. More than 3,500 people have died of COVID, and more than 12.6 million vaccines have been administered. This researcher says it's one of the more serious breaches of the past decade.
A, because of the issue it causes for that information itself, but B, because it erodes the trust that people have in the government handling their personal information.
There's always an ongoing risk of insider threat to personal health information, and large organisations, including Te Whatu Ora, are very aware of these risks and very aware of the high level of targeting of the health sector right around the world.
Barry Young hasn't yet entered a plea and is due to get bail tomorrow afternoon. Kushla Norman, One News.